Hello friends, today we'll look into making an all-purpose universal fertilizer for all your home plants for boosting the growth or increasing flowering or fruiting. This topic is a little controversial as we are using a mixture of organic as well as inorganic NPK fertilizers, and we shall try to prepare a balanced universal fertilizer combination that will balance the benefits of both organic as well as inorganic fertilizers. This is based on my own scientific research and methods. And the university research article links are provided in the video description, and also the links to purchase stuff online if it's not available in your place. All that is coming up. Welcome back. If you're a hobby gardener or interested in growing plants, consider subscribing to this channel. Also turn on the notification bell icon so that you won't miss any updates. Well, for both beginners and experienced gardeners, a good nutrient-rich soil is the most important factors for gardening success. Well, this applies when you're using the best soil with all nutrients to be readily available to the plants. You can watch my separate video on universal potting soil by checking the link in the video description and also from a card linked at top right corner of this video. But let's finish this video. Well, back to the topic. What if you have not prepared the best potting soil for your plants and your plants are suffering from malnutrition and some deficiencies? Also, if you already have the best soil available to your plants, what about supplementing it with nutrients? I mean, fertilizing your plants for the best growth and development is very important. Whether to practice organic gardening methods or to rely upon chemical products, it's a major decision in soil management. Weighing the advantages and disadvantages of natural and chemical fertilizers will help you decide which method is appropriate for your garden. There are many advantages as well as disadvantages of both organic and inorganic fertilizers. We'll not go into details of these right now. We'll discuss this in some other detailed video some other time. For now, based on some research articles on mixed organic and inorganic fertilizer preparation, that is to utilize the benefits of both, and considering the NPK proportions and micronutrient or trace element proportions, we'll try to formulate a preparation to fertilize your plants and use this mixture as an all-purpose universal fertilizer, that is a powder to fertilize your plants on a monthly or fortnightly basis. If you want to know what is NPK and go to some basics, there is a separate video on NPK fertilizer. You can check the link in description or from a video card link at top right corner. The basic idea is to make a balanced general purpose or the universal fertilizer. Like you get a general purpose NPK crystals of 19-19-19 or 12-12-12 proportions and so on. This indicates nitrogen 19%, phosphorus 19% and potash 19% and things like that. If you are an expert, you can do more calculations and research and also consider your purpose or even make a plant specific combinations by varying these proportions. For this, you should know the approximate concentration of NPK in each of these organic stuff that you are adding. Also, there are fertilizer mixing apps on Google Play Store. You can check that. Well, let's look into the ingredients we'll be using. And if you do not have some of these, do not worry. You can use whatever is available based on the content of NPK in each. For this, you can check the NPK percentages and then total it at the end to know the actual or approximate value of your final fertilizer mixture. Also, one more concept to keep in mind is, unlike chemical fertilizers, the natural fertilizers tend to dissolve slowly and thereby release the nutrients slowly. That is, they are slow releasing fertilizers, whereas chemical NPKs are readily available for the plants to uptake it. This way, we are balancing the nutrient availability and avoiding the adverse effects of too much chemical fertilizers by using a lesser amount of inorganic, that is chemical fertilizers. The first ingredient we are using is the cow dung, decomposed cow dung. But whatever animal manure you are using, take a look at the NPK ratios of these. Here we are using decomposed cow dung. So NPK is 3, 2 and 1. So for your reference, please have a look at the NPK values of each of these animal manures. Then the next stuff we are using is compost, whether homemade compost or vermicompost. Here we are adding vermicompost, which also contains many useful trace elements. Have a look at the tables for your reference. So the NPK is approximately 1.78, 0.77 and 0.94. It also contains many trace elements. Then the third ingredient is the bone meal. You can use any of the other meals like the sterile meal, fish meal, blood meal, and so on. So the NPK for bone meal is 3.5, 18, and 0. That is no potash. Here we'll add both steamed bone meal powder as well as the coarse bone meal chips powder mixed. Do not worry if you have, if you do not have any of these, you can add any one of this. This is just to make it quicker for the release of bone meal nutrients. Then next ingredient we'll be using is optional, that is for additional fortification, and also it has soil pesticide and pest repellent activities, particularly neem cake powder or karanj powder. Then we'll also add some mustard cake powder. We'll discuss the benefits of each of these in separate videos because the video will get longer if I continue speaking about these things. Well, the first one is neem cake powder. NPK of neem cake powder is nitrogen 2 to 5%, phosphorus 0.5 to 1%, and potash 1 to 2%. So now after knowing the NPK proportions, we can now mix these stuff in different proportions to make your universal fertilizer mixture. There are a lot of formulae, calculations, and mathematics to determine the NPK value, etc. of all these type of mixtures, but at home gardening level, we'll not bother too much about this. I'm not a horticulturist or an expert in this field. I'm a medical doctor with gardening as my hobby and passion. Anyways, we'll try to make an approximate mix with approximate proportions and use this on your plants. If you are a pure organic fertilizer lover, then you can prepare organic only fertilizer by adding only organic stuff. If you want to prepare a balanced universal mix, that is inorganic plus organic mixture, you need to offer this in lesser quantity to your plants, like half to one tablespoon depending on the size of your pot, and also after tilling or raking the topsoil, and then apply around the plant, not directly on the roots. You can apply every 15 days to 1 month by carefully evaluating your results and also then adjusting the dosage accordingly. Well, now we'll mix all these with approximate weight of each of these in grams to make this fertilizer mix of organic plus inorganic. That is a total of up to 10 kgs, that is 10 kilograms. First component is urea with NPK value of 4600. That is about, we'll add about 200 grams. Then NPK powdered crystals or water soluble powder form, that is available as a foliar spray. You can add this with NPK value 19, 19, 19. You can add about 500 grams. You can also crush the NPK crystals before adding if you do not have this powdered NPK. Then DAP with NPK value 18, 46 and 0. You can add 500 grams. Similarly, you can crush these crystals too and then add. Then cow dung powder, you can add about 2000 grams, that is 2 kgs. Then add compost, homemade compost or vermicompost, about 2000 grams, that is 2 kgs. If you do not have micronutrient powder, you can increase this to 3000 or 4000 grams. Next ingredient is bone meal. We're adding 1 kilogram, that is 1000 grams of bone meal powder. The next thing is an optional neem cake powder or karanj powder. You can add both 500 grams each or either of these 1000 grams. Then mustard cake powder, you can add 1000 grams. This is very good for flowering and fruiting plants. Then Epsom salt, you can add about 200 grams. Then lastly, we'll optionally fortify this further with additional micronutrient powder available from some reputed company. That is to add micronutrients like manganese, zinc, iron, boron and many others to safeguard our plants from any deficiencies. Also, you can add more ingredients you wish to, like used tea powder and any other stuff, because this is a one-time mix and you offer this on a periodic basis and only once in 15 days or so. And you add almost all nutrients to this mix, and this reduces the burden and saves you a lot of time. Plus, this is a quality mix. Then optionally, you can perform a soil pH test and mix either wood ash or lime to make your soil more alkaline if it's too acidic. And if your soil is too alkaline, you can add alum powder into the mix. You can watch separate video on wood ash and also alum powder from my video playlist. And one more important point from storage point of view, you might feel some moisture in this mixture due to some moist ingredients. You can either use completely dry ingredients before mixing, or you can dry this whole mixture in sunlight and then store in airtight containers. Remember to mix the ingredients thoroughly well for best results. Now we'll roughly total up the NPK value for this mix. We'll try to make it simple by totaling up based on 1000 grams of each of these ingredients. Just have a look at this equation in the table. So the approximate total NPK value of this mix is 49, 57 and 70. If you want to reduce the nitrogen value, you can skip adding urea and things like that. So the take home message is, this mix is powerful mix of organic and inorganic fertilizers, balancing the advantages and disadvantages of chemical fertilizers. And secondly, it saves your time and energy, and you offer everything at once to your plants. So there we have it, folks. That was an attempt to make our own universal fertilizer mix for our home garden plants. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up, then comment something below the video, and also share it on social media to support this channel. Some references and links to research articles are given in the description box. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing to the channel. Happy gardening!